Now let's see the supply function. So what is supply function? Supply function refers to functional relationship between quantity supplied for a particular commodity and the factors influencing it. Here we see individual supply function and market supply function. Individual supply function refers to functional relationship between supply and factors affecting the supply of a commodity. So which is expressed as xx is equal to function of px, po, pf, st, t and g. That means sx stands for supply of a given commodity x. That is equal to function of px is price of given commodity x, po price of other goods, pf price of factors of production, st state technology, t is taxation policy, g is goals of the firm. So here you find the factors influencing the supply. So function of factors influence supply is supply function of a given commodity. Next, market supply function. That refers to a functional relationship between market supply and forces, factors affecting the market supply of a commodity. The relationship between market supply and factors affecting the market supply of a commodity. So here you find this SX. So SX stands for market supply of a given commodity X. That is equal to function of PX, price of given commodity X, price of other goods, price of factors of production, ST state of technology, T taxation, G goals of the firms, then N is number of firms in the market, they're doing the production, then F future expectation regarding price of given commodity X, M is for means of transportation and communication. So these are all the factors affecting the supply. So this is regarding market supply. Now we'll see the individual supply curve and market supply curve. Supply schedule is a tabular statement showing various quantities of a commodity being supplied at various levels of price during a given period of time. So there will be a schedule showing individual supply, so price and quantity supplied. So price, for example, for rupees 1, 5 units of goods supply, rupees 2, 10 units of goods supply, 3, 15 units, then 4, 20 units, 5, 25 units. So the producer is willing to sell 5 units of goods at X. Then here you find one price, 1 rupee. For 5 units of goods, he is ready to sell for 1 rupee. So when the price rises to 2 rupees, the supply rises to 10. So you find when the price rises to 5 rupees, the quantity supplied is 25. So from 5 to 25, it gets increased. Then when you take a market supply schedule, you will be seeing the supply curve of or supply schedule of 2 or 3 markets, the number of firms in the production. So you find the details of each firm is given, individual supply is given. Then you add it up and do market supply. Now we have a diagrammatic representation. Look at the individual supply, what I told you just now. At 1 rupee, the producer supplies 5 units of goods. Then at 2 rupees, 10 units. Then 3, 15 units. 4, 10, sorry, 20 units. 5, 25 units. So this is the supply curve. So when price increases, you find the quantity supplied also increases. So that shows a direct relationship between price and quantity supplied, keeping the other factors constant. So it can be supply curve can be drawn for any commodity by plotting the each combination of supply schedule on a graph. So individual supply curve refers to graphical representation of individual supply schedule. So this is the example. So from you find, so these are all A, B, C are the points or the data given in the schedule. These are meeting points, the price and quantity. That's A point. At point A it is plotted. Then for the next unit you find at point B it is plotted. So by joining all the points you get the supply curve. Its slope upwards because of positive relationship. Now we'll see market supply curve. So here in market supply curve you can find the individual supply. So SA, SB, SM, these are all individual firms. The market supply, here you find SM, that is the market supply curve. So SA and SB are individual supply curves and SM is market, that is what, remember M. So SM is market supply curve. That is obtained by horizontal summation of individual supply curve. So what do you mean by that? Horizontal summation means if individual supply firm supplies 5 units at rupee 1, then SA supplies at 5 rupees, the 5 at 1 rupee, SA supplies 5 units of product, then SB supplies 10 units. So market supply is 5 plus 10, 15. That is what horizontal summation. If there are 3 firms, then the units of supply added, the 3, that is 3, the units of supply by the 3 individual firms are added, and that is market supply. So SM is acquired by, or you get SM by horizontal summation of individual firms. So here you find SM is flatter than SA and SB because with a change in price, the proportionate change in market supply is more than the proportionate change in individual supplies. That is big. Here you find the change steeper, but here you find it is flatter. That is because we are adding up the units supplied. So when you are adding up the units supplied, you find the difference. So what kind of difference? It is more. That is, you can look at the change. Together, all together, what is the change in the market supply? So with the change in price, the proportionate change in the market supply is more than the proportionate change in individual supply. That is why SM is flatter than SA and SB. So how do you arrive at that? How do you find the slope of supply curve? Change in price divided by change in quantity supplied. So due to direct relationship between price and supply, the supply curve slopes upwards. So slope is positive. And slope of supply curve measures the flatness or steepness of the supply curve. So it is based on the absolute change in price and quantity. So you have to find out what is the change in price, what is the change in quantity. For example, when a price rises from rupees 4 to rupees 8, the quantity supplied increases from 2 units to 4 units. So the slope of a supply curve can be calculated by change in price. What is the change in price? 4, 8. So difference is 4. Then quantity changes 2 units, 4 units. So 2. So 4 divided by 2. It's equal to 2. So the 2 is the slope of supply curve.